Hello, I'm Paul Rashidi with the Google Cloud Platform team. Now that Compute Engine is open for everyone to use, I thought it would be fun to do a demo of using Compute Engine to set up a cloud-based web server. That way you can see the process and then try it out for yourself. Let's get started by pointing your browser to cloud.google.com/console. When you first come to the cloud platform, you'll be prompted to create a new project. We're creating a test web server, so we'll call it Web Server Project. We'll change the suggested project ID as well, and then click Create. That'll start the creation process. Now that the project's being created, we will have access to all of Google Cloud Platform services. Compute Engine is a paid service, so the first thing we'll need to do is set up our billing information. You'll likely be surprised at how affordable experimenting with Compute Engine can be. I'm going to go ahead and fill out the billing details and be right back. After we've entered our billing information, we'll navigate to the Compute Engine Instances page, where we'll see a list of the virtual machines that we've created. We don't currently have any, so let's add one. We're going to create an instance called Test Web Server. Start by clicking the New Instance button at the top of the page. We'll specify the name as Test Web Server. For the zone, we'll create our instance in US Central 1A. For the machine type, since this is a test, we'll select the smallest one available, the F1 Micro with one virtual CPU and just over a half a gigabyte of RAM. We'll go with the suggested default image, which is Debian. All other settings should be okay for our purposes. Now we can click the Create button to create the virtual machine. Our instance is almost ready. Some final health checks are being run, which is the last step before the server is ready to use. There, now our instance has been created. By default, Google Compute Engine blocks all connections to an instance from the internet. Since we want to serve web pages with our instance, we'll need to set up a firewall to specify that incoming HTTP traffic is allowed on the network where our newly created virtual machine resides. We can do that by clicking Networks. Select the default network, which is what we attach to our virtual machine. Click the Create New link that appears at the top of the firewall section. Name the firewall HTTP1, and then in the protocol ports field, enter TCP80. Click the Create button to complete the creation of the firewall. Once this process is complete, we should see the new firewall appear in the firewalls list. And there it is. In order to make changes like installing software on our Compute Engine virtual machine, we need to remotely access the machine. The Google Compute Engine team has created a great tool for doing this called GCUtil, which is included in the Google Cloud SDK. The instructions for downloading and installing GCUtil can be found at developers.google.com/cloud/SDK. You'll essentially download a zip file, extract it, and run an install script. Then run an authentication script and grant the tool access. I'll go ahead and speed through that process now. The authentication command here is what grants the SDK access to work with your project. An OAuth2 token is being issued and stored through this process. We're now set up to use GCUtil. Once we've installed GCUtil on our machine, we can use it to remotely access the instance we created. There's a quick way to do that if you go to the Instance Details page. On the side there, there's an SSH link. Copy the SSH command that's provided there. Open a terminal window and paste the SSH command in to run it. If you're prompted for a passphrase, enter something you can remember for your SSH keys. The very first time you use a key with a project, it will take a few minutes to upload the key. And there we go. We've remotely accessed our test web server, and here we are on the command line. Well, let's install some software, specifically some web server software. The web server we're going to install is Apache. A standard command used on Linux to install software is apt-get. So we're going to type sudo to run the command as the super user, apt-get install Apache 2. It's going to ask us to confirm we want to install it. Hit Y and type enter. The installation process has started. And now Apache has been installed. As part of the installation process, Apache creates a default web page. So let's jump back to a browser to test if we can load the default web page that Apache has created. Now to find our default page, so that we can try to load it in the browser, we need to know the internet address of our test web server. We can find that back on the VM instances page. Locate the external IP and copy it. Open a new tab in your browser and paste it in. And there we go, the default Apache web page. Great! Our test web server is serving up pages. Now to prove that this is our web server, let's modify the default web page. We'll jump back over to our terminal window and type the following command to open our default web page in a text editor. We'll start by typing sudo to run the command as superuser, then nano, which is the text editor we'll use, and then the location of the Apache default web page, which is var www.index.html. When we run that, it opens the index.html file in the nano text editor. First, we'll remove the default text that's there, and then we can paste in an image so we can easily tell that the page has been modified. We'll save the file with command O and hit enter, and then command X to exit. Back in the browser, we should be able to refresh the page, and there's our custom default web page. Now I would call this test a success. The final thing we need to do to wrap up our test is to delete the virtual machine we created and the persistent disk. As I do this, let's make a calculation about how much this whole test costs. First, to perform the delete, we'll select our test web server VM, then scroll down and click the Delete This Instance button. We'll check the option for deleting the boot disk that was created with our VM, and then click OK. The deletion process has started. Regarding the cost, the current virtual machine price for the type we used is 1.9 cents per hour. We ran our server for around 10 minutes, so our virtual machine usage cost comes in at just under a third of a cent. And there we go, the virtual machine has been deleted. The persistent disk pricing is 4 cents per gigabyte per month, so that roughly comes to just under half a cent for 500 gigabyte boot disk, the suggested. So everything we did on Compute Engine, we did for less than 1 cent. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn. Go try creating your own cloud-based web server on Compute Engine.